There was once a cat that dreamed of being an astronaut. She loved space. She studied it in her free time while the other cats would sleep. One day, she got an invitation to go to the moon. She was thrilled. So, what she did was she took her moon pass with her onto the rocket. She had her astronaut suit on. She sat down, and then she wrapped up, and what happened was she trudged along in the air until she reached the colossal, amazing moon. That's where giant ship arrived. She got on board and met many fellow creatures. They were alien specimens from the moon. To start, there was a puffy little hedgehog, it looked to be. "Hello," she said.
"Hi,"
the puffball responded back.
"Name Cuddles. Are you a foreigner from Earth?"
She replied, "Yes, yes I am. And I've always dreamed to be the first cat to go to space."
"That's swell. I will invite you in here. But do you have a moon pass?"
"Oh no, I left it in my rocket.
Gotta jump."
So she jumped back into her rocket, trying to get through the times of heavy air pressure, and she searched and searched, but she could not find her moon pass. But then she saw it in the distance. A great jump she made to obtain her leap, her moon pass. She then had to make it back to the moon.
"I'm back, Cuddles. I have my moon pass."
"Your
ID is verified.
Yay." So, as she voyaged along, she met the moon moon master named Blue.
"Hello, Blue. Hello, Blue. All bow down."
With a mighty grumble, Blue spoke, "How
you get here when you are a cat?
She said, I have the moon pass and I'm the first cat on the moon. Do you see my moon ball?
Yes, I do see it. It's very strange. Have you come from Earth?
Yes. Yes, I have.
I see. You shall be free to explore all treasures and equipment found in the moon.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
She found a structure of a superior egg. This is really cool to learn about the history and cultures of the moon.
She walked over and she jumped due to that little ground. She also found many stones.
This appears to be a moon rock.
It's really cool. It's even bigger than my main ball.
I'll add it to my collection.
She threw it in the rocket for later. And she found a large gem, it looked to be.
This appears to be a large chunk of meteor that may have struck it.
Now, I know in real life, guys, that it's just a geolimp, but I'm going to pretend that it's like a crash meteor.
She was fascinated by it.
She was ready to take it when Blue yelled up and jumped, "No!"
"What? What are you doing, Hogan?" Master Blue.
"You cannot take that stone. Holds our rights and preciousness. Without it, all culture and civilization on the moon would be lost. You cannot take this."
"Okay, I understand."
And she had found, 1 second later, a fallen star.
"What is this? It's supposed to be a fallen star."
She touched it and felt warmth go through her bodysuit.
"Wow, this feels very nice."
"Ah,
meow, 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 meow."
Now her body was heated up. She had basked in the warmth. But she realized that her treasures were been gone. So she packed up her moon path, said goodbye to her fellow friends, and left.
"Goodbye, Blair."
"Goodbye."
"Bye-bye, Cuddles. Bye, fellow Earthling. You will be my friend." "Okay, I promise I will visit sometime soon again."
"Okay." Bundled up her moon pass and headed back to Earth. The end.